Okay, everybody, your attention, please. One of my gloves. Okay, I know it's, first of all, I'd like to welcome, on behalf of David and myself and for Curtis, welcome everybody here tonight to a wonderful exhibition. Sometimes it's an overused statement to say that Curtis doesn't need an introduction, but we will introduce him, and I will allow Saeb here to do that introduction. But firstly, as news came through this evening, I'm sure a lot of you have been following the big Palestinian hunger strike that's been going on. And this evening, Mahmoud Sassart, who is on his 91st day of hunger strike, apparently has done a deal and he is to be released on the 17th of July. So it's not often really good news from Palestine and Gaza, but we got that this evening. Anyway, Curtis Latuff, a fantastic political cartoonist, world-renowned. We're very, very lucky to have him in Ireland. Yesterday we were in Derry and he painted on the museum wall and on the Free Derry corner. And tomorrow he will be painting on the international wall up on the Falls Road. So if you are about tomorrow, feel free to come along in the afternoon and be working there. So without further ado, I'll let Saeb say a couple of words. Be very, very quick this time, Saeb. And Saeb will introduce Curtis. Curtis will say a few words, and then he's free for a question and answer session, so feel free to ask him any questions. He's threatened to speak in Portuguese, but we'll hold him to that. So, Saeb.
Good evening, everyone. Curtis represents an institute in itself, a school in political thought. Curtis is a symbol of real internationalism in action, in struggle against imperialism and against capitalism and for liberation movement. Curtis focused on the noble cause of Palestine and from that, the Arab Revolution, all as one. Curtis, with a very simple drawing and picture, can explain the cause and the injustices the Palestinian people faced and are facing, and the Arab Revolution till today has been cheated of its achieving its goal of liberation and sovereign, to be sovereign in their own land by imperialists and their own puppets in the Middle East. So this institute arrived to Belfast a few days ago, went to Derry, and brought the whole causes all together for us to stand for ourselves. I give you Curtis Latuff.
First of all, I would like to thank you all for coming, and thank you very much, John, for bringing me here and to give me this unique opportunity to talk to the Irish from North. You know, he say we say we are Irish. But I used to say the Irish from North because the North has a special touch for me, you know. And for me, he's the witness how I felt when I put my feet for the first time in the North Ireland. It was like putting my feet on Palestine, you know. It's different. I'm open for questions about Palestine. Of course, you know, you're gonna see many of my cartoons. I spent 13 years making cartoons about Palestine, but I would like to say something about North Ireland. It's because for me it was a dream to be here. I got the impression the establishment the Irish establishment here is trying to convince people and the world that the situation here was solved. There is no longer problems, everything is okay, Olympic torch, welcoming the queen, you know, all this kind of shit. But, even for me as a Brazilian, it's pretty clear this is shit, bullshit, you know? And I had the opportunity in 3 days to visit memorials of people killed by the British government. Tombs, talked to families of people who were shot down during the Sunday, Bloody Sunday, right, in Derry. So I think the situation here, the problem here was not solved, was delayed, you know? It's like walking in a volcanic land, you know? You cannot see the flame, you cannot see the fire, but it's under, you know? It's the situation here. And if I was Irish, I would be ashamed, offended, to have Derry called as the UK city of culture. For me, it's pretty clear the Irish are not the British. To call an Irish a British is offensive. It's clear for everyone, even for me, a Brazilian. So, you know, it's like calling Derry Londonderry, you know? So, I like to express my solidarity with you, Irish, with your history of resistance, with my deep respect for those who died fighting the anti-colonialism struggle, and the families who are struggling against the impunity, because those responsible for the max, the
bogside
massacre were not put under the justice, you know. So I would like to express my solidarity, my respect, and to say welcome you in this exhibition, and express my to say how glad I am for being here and talk to you and put my feet here. Thank you very much.